In the famous and, in our opinion, best Terminator movie, Terminator 2 Judgment Day, the titular Terminator ends the film by lowering himself into a blazing hot crucible full of molten metal. The extreme temperatures are the only way to ensure his total destruction, and though that complete destruction of all his hardware ensure that humanity averts Judgment Day by never developing the tech that will lead to Skynet. Yet, Judgment Day was always inevitable, making the gesture largely meaningless. But it has always made us think about what would happen to a human body that fell into a large ladle full of molten metal. Well, it seems like viewer Mark had the same idea, because he told us that he worked at a steel mill, and he always wondered, what if you fell into one of those superheated metal ladles? Today, steel and other industrial metals are made in the furnaces known as electric arc furnaces. Back when humanity was stuck with wood and bellows to heat up metal and melt it, we were limited to the ultimate purity and strength we could achieve with different materials. Then the electric arc furnace was invented, and let us cook a witch's brew of metals and other compounds together at incredible temperatures. An industrial EAF can reach temperatures of up to 3,272 degrees, while those made for laboratory use can reach temperatures of a staggering 5,432 degrees. That's just under 2,000 degrees shy of the temperature at the middle of a big sunspot, and well over the 1,292 to 2,192 degrees of freshly spewed lava. Based off of these facts alone, our team of world-class researchers can already tell you that if you were to fall inside a freshly poured ladle of molten steel, well, things would be bad. Really, really bad. And that's a scientific opinion. Let's imagine that you, like our curious viewer Mark, got yourself a job at a steel mill. On break one day, you and your buddy look at the white-hot ladles full of metal and get a clever idea. Wouldn't it make for a very awesome TikTok video to jokingly recreate part of the final scene of Terminator 2? Very quickly, you decided that yes, yes, it would be awesome. And so you go about preparing to become internet superstars. First, you shimmy up onto a length of chain hanging from the ceiling. Then your buddy climbs up on a catwalk over you to get the perfect angle. Then, as a freshly poured ladle is pushed along underneath you, you look up, big cheesy smile on your face, and dark Terminator sunglasses on, and let go with one hand to form Arnold Schwarzenegger's iconic thumbs up. The moment you let go of that chain, you realize just how slippery it is, and you suddenly can't keep a grip with the one hand you're holding on. With a flash of panic, you realize this is it. You're tumbling backwards, and you're about to be a real-life science experiment. What would happen to you? Well, luckily for you, it would all be over relatively quick. Unluckily for you, the few seconds it'll actually take to be over for you are going to be the most painful of your life. First, as you're falling through the air, you're hit with a layer of superheated air right above the metal ladle. As it's been freshly poured full of molten steel at a temperature of 3,000 degrees, the air just a few feet above the ladle is going to be heated to a few hundred degrees. If you watched our older episode on what happens to your body inside a volcano, then you know that you'd catch fire long before you hit the actual lava. In this case, though, there isn't enough molten metal to generate the heat required to superheat the air to temperatures that would make you spontaneously combust. Also, the lack of a funnel, like a volcano's rim, means that most of the heat dissipates into the environment pretty quickly. What will happen to you, though, as you fall backwards in slow motion, is that all exposed skin on your backside will instantly get the worst sunburn of your life. Clothing materials with very low flash points, such as cotton, could ignite, but mostly your clothes would remain flame-free. In the next few split seconds of falling, you'll reach the air just a few inches above the molten metal. Here, the temperature is going to be in excess of 1,000 degrees, rapidly dropping as convection carries superheated air away. At this point, your clothes will either melt to your body or carbonize, falling prey to the incredible heat too quickly to actually catch fire. Waste gases being vented from within the molten metal could also make sure that in this few inches thick layer of air you're falling into, there's not much oxygen for actual flames to occur. We guess that's good news. But honestly, at this point, it doesn't really matter because you'll only be here for a few tenths of a second. The exposed flesh on your backside will be frying, with burns reaching deep enough to hit bone. The hair on the backside of your head will be burnt away as quick as if you stuck your eyebrows too close to a grill being lit. Just a few tenths of a second later, your body will hit the molten metal. This is where things go from bad to worse. You might be picturing a death similar to the Terminators from the movie, and at this point, you're probably hoping for it. After all, you're already falling to your death inside a ladle full of molten metal. You might as well seal the deal on the most badass TikTok of all time. Sadly for you, though, the Terminator was made of some unspecified super dense material, while you're made of wimpy old flesh and bones. The molten metal you're falling into is incredibly dense. It is metal, after all, and far too dense for you to have any hope of sinking in. Again, if you've seen our video on what happens to your body in a volcano, then you already know this. But you're basically going to smack into a super dense surface, hard enough to give you a nasty concussion. The Terminator only sunk because he was so dense, though to be honest, we have some serious scientific questions about that scene. Being engulfed by superheated metal would have been your best option, to be sure. At least it would have ensured a very quick death. Instead, you'll fall flat on your back onto a molten surface that's still dense enough to keep you afloat. At this point, some parts of your body will actually be protected from incineration for a few milliseconds, thanks to a quirk of physics. Moisture in the areas will flash evaporate in a process known as sublimation, which will, for just a few milliseconds, completely protect you from harm. You can actually experience this for yourself with a candle and a wet finger. Simply hold the thoroughly wet finger over a candle, and you'll notice that for a very brief moment, you're completely protected from the effect of the flame. Of course, this works a lot better with the relatively low heat of a stove or a candle, and in this scenario, you'll only be protected for an infinitesimally small amount of time, but just long enough to squeeze in another millisecond or two of absolute pain. The good news, though, is that most of that pain is going to very rapidly disappear because laying on top of a molten pile of metal is going to sear away every nerve ending on your backside, and with no nerves, there'll be no pain. Of course, that leaves the entire front side of your body jam-packed with pain-sensing nerves, and the rapidly spreading heat is going to definitely give them something to scream about to your brain. Honestly, your best bet would just be to roll over and finish the job. Sear off all the nerve endings like you're a burger being flipped for a proper grilling. Of course, your brain isn't going to be able to process information much longer. By now, the incredible heat will have turned most of the moisture inside your skull into steam, and all that steam is going to need to find a way out of your head. Your skull is pretty good at resisting expanding pressure, but unluckily for you, your eyeballs definitely aren't. In the few short seconds it would take for you to actually die, the explosive venting of steam from your skull could actually make one or both of your eyeballs pop out of your head, and with the optic nerve still attached, you'd still be able to see just fine. Or you would, at least if your brain wasn't then immediately going to be shutting down from a combination of being torn apart by the explosive venting and the searing from blood and water flash boiling throughout its tissues, and the rapidly growing heat as the back of your skull dissolves. Luckily for you, it's pretty much lights out at this point, though it's here that your top half would likely catch fire, if only briefly. Your flesh would melt away pretty easily, then followed by your bones. Your teeth, though, are surprisingly tough and can survive temperatures of up to 1,000 degrees, so they'll be the last to go. If you have metal fillings, though, some of them might actually survive, since these can have melting points of up to 1,600 degrees. Within just a few seconds, all that'll be left of you will be a few wisps of smoke and a TikTok video with a very disappointing missed opportunity, because you forgot the thumbs up at the end, didn't you? In the end, falling into a metal ladle is probably one of the worst ways to die. For only a few short seconds, though, it is, however, a really good way to get fired from your job. Pun fully intended. Of course, by contaminating the very precise mix of molten metal and carbon that goes into each pore of molten steel, you'll ensure that the entire mixture is useless and will have to be refired. If you happen to work at a steel mill, well, there's probably better ways to rage quit your job, but you know, it is an option. Probably because working with molten metal is so dangerous, though, we were unable to find a single incident of this happening. But if you've watched our episodes on the worst forms of torture from ancient times, then we can only hope that one day in some dystopian future, some insane ruler will order people dropped into molten electric arc furnaces as an execution method. Until then, you could be a pioneer. What do you think the worst way to die would be? Have a question only the Infographics show can answer? Let us know in the comments or email us. And while you're here, check out our other video on what happens to your body in a volcano. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great content.